Hello everyone. Today we continue with the applications of solubility product. Applications of solubility product means uses of solubility product. So the first one is that in calculation of solubility of a sparingly soluble salt. A solubility means what? S can be calculated if you know what now solubility product. So for HCl, if solubility is what now S moles per liter. Solubility is S. Then AgCl gives rise to what? Ag plus and Cl minus. And it is always in the reversible condition. Okay. It is sparingly soluble salt. Na? Ag plus and Cl minus will form here. And Ksp of this AgCl can be given as what? Ag plus concentration to the power of 1 into Cl minus concentration to the power of 1. And Ag plus how much here? Initially 1 mole we have taken. Initially 0 and 0 we have taken. And from 1 mole, how much dissolved S? So S moles per liter dissolved. So S is called what? Solubility product. So if S is dissolved here 1 is there, now 1 Ag plus, now, so 1 S will form. Here also 1 Cl minus, now, so 1 S will form here. So that is S and S. So Ag plus concentration is S, Cl minus concentration is S at equilibrium. Then what happens? S into S, S square. So Ksp is equal to S square, then S is equal to what now here? Square root of Ksp. The same thing how to write now here, solubility S is equal to Ksp to the power of what? 1 by 2. Okay? That is square root of what? Square root of Ksp. So square root of Ksp is equal to what? Solubility. So if you know Ksp value, we can find out solubility, and the solubility will be obtained in which units now? Moles per liter. If you are asked in grams per liter, the number of moles into gram molecular weight will give grams per liter. Second use is that in guessing precipitation on mixing two solutions. If you mix two solutions now, the precipitation will occur or not, we can understand by using what? Solubility product Ksp value. So on mixing two solutions, if ionic product, how to represent K IPR SP, K, IP. IP indicates what? Ionic product. If ionic product exceeds, means what? Increases. Means becomes more. Okay. Becomes more than solubility product. A solubility product, how to write? K, SP. KSP indicates what here? Solubility product. KSP indicates what? Solubility product. So now if KIP means what? Ionic product of the solution is more than what? Exceeds what? The solubility product, the precipitation is formed in which condition? What is the condition for precipitation here? KIP should be more than KSP. Okay, the ionic product should be more than solubility product. Then what will happen here? Precipitation will occur. And if ionic product is less than solubility product, no precipitation is formed here. So no precipitation forms in which case? If KIP is less than what? KSP. SP means solubility product. IP means what? Ionic product. That point we have to understand. Okay. Next, third application. Third use is what? Qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis means if you are given unknown salts. If you are given unknown salt, some powder is given, salt powder. Which cation is present in that given salt? If you are asked, we have to conduct a series of experiments, series of tests. So cationic test, anionic test we have to do. So this process is called what now? Qualitative analysis. Finding out which cation is present in the unknown salt and which anion is present is called what? Salt analysis, otherwise qualitative analysis. Okay. For example, in group 2 of qualitative analysis, a group 2 means not IUPAC group number, not alkaline earth metals. It's not alkaline earth metals. It is not alkaline earth metals. It is what now? Group 2 cations. So all cations are coming from bases, na? Basic radicals we say, cations. All cations are classified into different groups. Group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4, group 5 like this. Okay. So now here, for example, in group 2 of qualitative analysis, H2S gas is passed through HCl, acidic solution. H2S gas is passed through which solution? HCl solution. This decreases the sulfide ion concentration by common ion effect. So how it decreases, you see first. So first of all, you see the radicals here, group 1, group 2 here. What we need here, group 2 we need. Group 2 cations, what are they? Basic radicals, Cu plus 2, Cd plus 2, Pb plus 2, Hg plus 2, Bi plus 3. All these ions are what now here? Cadmium, mercury, Pb plus 2. These all are what now here? Basic radicals are cations. Cations, otherwise, basic radicals of what now here? Group 2. Okay, so now here, what is the group 2 reagent? The group 2 reagent is what? H2S gas in presence of HCl. H2S gas in presence of HCl. Okay, so like that here, if you take group 4, group 4 cations. Group 4 cations, what are their radicals? Basic radicals, zinc plus 2, Ni plus 2, Mn plus 2, CO plus 2. These are group 4 radicals. Okay, now these radicals can be identified by using which reagent? H2S gas in ammonical medium. Ammonical medium means what? NH4OH. In NH4OH, H2S plus NH4OH. H2S plus NH4OH will be the group reagent, group 4 reagent to identify the cations. And group 1, what here? H2S plus dilute HCl. H2S plus dilute HCl will be group reagent of 2, group 2. So this point we have to understand. So first of all, you see here the reaction. Now H2S and HCl, H2S plus HCl, this is group reagent of what now? For group 2 basic radical, for group 2 cations, what is the reagent? H2S plus HCl. Now HCl is strong acid, it will dissociate completely to form H plus Cl minus, and H2S is weak acid, it will dissociate incompletely to form 2H plus and S minus 2 ions. Now sulfide ions are available here. Okay. Now H plus ion concentration increases. If you add what now here, if you add HCl to this equilibrium mixture, what happens, tell me? The HCl is producing what? H plus ions now. Now H plus ion concentration increases and equilibrium shifts backwards. Now we are in this equilibrium reaction, in first equilibrium reaction H2S, here 2H plus ions on which side? Product side, na? By adding HCl to this equilibrium mixture, we are adding what? H plus ions. These H plus ions, when we add product, what happens now here? Backward shifting will take place. When we add products, what happens? The backward reaction will be favored. Backward reaction is taking place means what happens now? S minus 2 ions will be decreasing. Whenever backward reaction is going on, the S minus 2 also will be decreasing. Na? S minus 2 will be decreasing, H plus will be consumed. So this increased H plus ions will take what? S minus 2 ions, and backward reaction will take place. Then what happens now? Backward shifting will take place, shifting towards backward direction. And if you take, suppose, group 4 reagent is what now? H2S plus NH4OH. It is what now? Group 4 reagent. Group 4 reagent. H2S gas is passed through what now? Base, weak base. Here H2S gas is passed through what? HCl acid. But here H2S gas is passed through NH4OH. Now in this case, NH4OH is what? Weak base now. Weak base. Now it will give what now? NH4 plus ions and OH minus ions. Okay. Now here what happens? Tell me here. The H plus ions combine with OH minus ions. Now here, when we add this NH4OH to H2S, tell me what happens now? When we add NH4OH to H2S, now the OH minus ions will take what now here? The H plus ions. The H plus ions will be taken by OH minus. The H plus ions in this equilibrium reaction will be taken by what happens here? OH minus. Now OH minus will combine what? H plus. Then H plus will be decreasing now. When H plus ions are decreasing, products are decreasing. When we remove products, which direction will be favored? Forward shifting will take place. When you remove the product H plus, what happens? The forward shifting will take place. A forward direction will be favored. When we add H2S gas, when we pass H2S gas through NH4OH, the OH minus ions will take what? H plus. Then what happens now here? Forward shifting will take place. Forward direction will be favored. Then more and more S minus 2 will be forming. S minus 2 forming more. More S minus 2 ions forming means what? The module concentration will be increasing in S minus 2 concentration. When S minus 2 concentration is increasing in forward direction, what happens now? Ionic product will be increasing. When ionic product becomes more than solubility product, what happens now? Precipitation will occur. The forward reaction is taking place. S minus 2 ions will be increasing. When S minus 2 increasing, ionic product will be increasing. When ionic product is increasing and becomes more than Ksp, solubility will be decreased and what here? Precipitation will occur. Like that, what here? The OH minus ions will remove the H plus when we add NH4OH. When we add HCl to H2S, the HCl will produce what? H plus ions. And we are adding what? H plus ions to this mixture now. When we add H plus ions product, what happens? Backward reaction will take place and S minus 2 will be decreasing. When S minus 2 ions concentration decreasing backward direction, what happens to ionic product? Ionic product will be decreasing. Ionic product will be decreasing. Is the concept clear, ma'am? So now in this case, H2S and NH4OH case, the H plus ions combine with what? OH minus ions, and H plus ion concentration decreases. This H plus will be removed now. H plus ion concentration decreases. Then equilibrium one, this one will shift towards what? Back forward direction. Means shifts forward. Okay. Now come back to this point here. HCl. Now what is the condition here? When H2S is passed through HCl. So H2S is passed through what now? Acidic solution of HCl. This process of addition of H2S decreases what now? S minus 2 concentration. When S minus 2 ion concentration decreases, when S minus 2 decreases, whatever ionic product will be decreased here. Okay, due to which ion effect now? Common ion effect. The S minus 2 concentration will be decreased. Why S minus 2 decreasing? Backward reaction will be favored for H2S. Okay, so here for H2S, backward direction will be favored. H plus and S minus 2. Now when backward reaction takes place, what happens now? S minus 2 concentration will decrease. And so that the only radicals of group 2 are precipitated. Group 2 radicals will be precipitated in this case. So whenever group 2 radicals are precipitating, meaning what? What will be more than what? KIP will be still more than what? KSP. Whenever KIP, ionic product, is more than solubility product, in that condition only precipitation will occur. And the group 2 sulfides will have. Group 2 sulfides have very low KSP values. Very lower values of KSP. That's why if ionic product is increasing also, if ionic product is decreasing also, the KSP value is very less now for these group 2 radicals. When KSP value is very less for the group 2 radicals, group 2 cation compounds, what happens now? Ionic product, though it is decreasing, still ionic product, the decreased ionic product still will be more than what? KSP. As KSP values are very low, though ionic product is decreasing, this decreased KIP value still will be more than what? KSP value only. Because KSP value of these salts will be very less, group 2 salts. That's why the KSP always will be less than what? KIP in the case of group 2. That's why what happens now here, precipitation will occur. Next, solubility products of whose sulfides, means secondary group sulfides are very low. In group 4, suppose, H2S gas is passed in ammonical medium. Ammonical medium means what now? NH4OH. H2S plus NH4OH will be reagent of group 4. This increases S minus 2 ion concentration. Here what happens in this case, forward direction will take place and S minus 2 ions concentration will be increasing. This increases S minus 2 ion concentration so that ionic product becomes what? Large enough. Ionic product becomes large enough to exceed what? The solubility product of sulfates of group 4. So in this case also what now here, precipitation, why it is occurring here? The precipitation of this fourth group salts will be occurring by ionic product becomes what? Ionic product becomes what? Large enough to exceed what? The solubility product. That's why what happens again in this case also, KIP will be very greater than KSP. That's why the precipitation occurs. PPT occurs. Precipitation process occurs here as KIP value very greater than KSP. Okay? So these points you have to understand here. Next, I will add this video once again, go through later. So group 2 radicals, group 3 radicals, group 4 radicals. The next one, And another application, another important application is that in salting out of soap, the process name is what? Salting out of soap. Now tell me, what is soap here? Soap is a salt or acid or base? Soap. Soap is a salt, remember. Soap is a salt. Salt of what? Weak acid plus strong base. Weak acid and strong base. Generally, strong base will be what? NaOH. Okay. From NaOH, Na plus will come. See here, soap. Soap's given what now? RCOO minus. RCOO minus and Na plus. Na plus cation is coming from strong base. And this anion RCOO minus is coming from some carboxylic acid. RCOOH, carboxylic acid. The carboxylic acid plus NaOH will combine to form soap. Soap is the salt, remember. Okay. Now, the soaps are precipitated. Soaps are precipitated out. This is called salting out of soap. Salting out of soap means what? Precipitation of soap. So, soaps are precipitated out from what? The solution. From the solution of soap. By adding what? By adding common salt. In common salt, what is common ion available? Na plus is there. Na plus is common ion with what? Na plus of soap. In soap, Na plus is there. In NaCl also, Na plus is there. Now, to this soap, what we are adding? NaCl we are adding. Then when NaCl is added, Na plus ions will become what? Common ions. Okay. It gives, this NaCl gives Na plus ions and the ionic product. Ionic product of what now? Anions into cations. The concentration of anions into concentration of cation of soap exceeds, the ionic product exceeds the solubility product. That means what now here? Which is becoming more than what? KIP. Ionic product is becoming more than what? KSP of soap. KSP of soap. Now KIP of soap. KIP of soap becomes more than what? KSP of soap. In this case, whenever KIP is more than KSP, precipitation occurs. This is called salting out of soap. So it can also be explained on the basis of common ion. So when we add water, common ion here, so how it will dissociate soap generally? Soap generally dissociates into what? RCOO Na dissociates into what? RCOO minus plus Na plus now. Now when we add what now here? NaCl. NaCl will dissociate completely into Na plus and Cl minus. Now here, what is common ion here? Na plus common ion. When we add NaCl to this equilibrium mixture, what happens? Na plus products we are adding here. When we add product, what happens? Backward reaction will take place. When backward reaction takes place, the ions will become what? Solid soap. The ions will become solid soap. So the soap will be coming out in the form of solid. So this is called salting out of soap. Salting out of soap. The soap molecules will be forming from ions. Backward reaction will take place due to common ion of Na+. Then what happens now? RCOO Na, soap molecules will be forming. So precipitation occurs. This is common ion effect. And another important application of solubility product is that in purification of common salt. In purification of common salt. Common salt means NaCl, na? NaCl dissociates into what generally? Na plus and Cl minus. When we add HCl to this, how it will be dissociated? H plus and Cl minus. Now when we pass HCl gas to NaCl, now which ions are common here? These two ions will be common. These two Cl minus will be common ions. When we add common ion, what happens now? Backward reaction also will take place. Backward reaction will take place. When backward reaction takes place, what is forming in backward reaction? The NaCl is forming. The pure NaCl will be precipitated. The pure NaCl will be coming out in the form of solid due to backward reaction. Why backward reaction is taking place here? Due to addition of common ion in the form of HCl gas. So, on passing HCl gas through the impure common salt. Impure common salt means common salt NaCl plus impurities. NaCl plus some impurities will be there here. Okay. So, now when we pass HCl gas through impure common salt solution, pure NaCl precipitates out. The pure NaCl will be forming in backward direction. So, pure NaCl will be precipitated out. This can be again explained as what now? Common ion effect. Explained due to what now? Explained by common ion effect. Common ion effect means what now here? Due to addition of Cl minus common ion, backward reaction takes place and pure NaCl will be precipitated. So it is purification of common salt, and previous one is salting out of soap. And also the solubility product can be used in explaining what now? Fractional precipitation. Fractional precipitation means what now? If two salts dissolved in water salt 1, salt 2 dissolved. Which salt will be precipitated first? Low KSP value or high KSP value? The salt with lower KSP value will be precipitated first. That is called what? Fractional precipitation. Like fractional distillation, it is fractional precipitation. So in explaining fractional precipitation, we can use the concept of solubility product. So for example, if K2CrO4, how it will dissociate? A 2 K plus ions will be there. 1 CrO4 minus 2 will be there. A single CrO4 minus 2 anion, chromate. Potassium chromate, not dichromate. Dichromate different, K2Cr2O7. K2Cr2O7 is potassium dichromate, but K2CrO4 is potassium chromate. For example, if potassium chromate solution is added slowly to a solution which is 0.1 molar in Ba plus 2 and 0.1 molar Sr plus 2, 0.1 molar Ba plus 2. Now Ba plus 2, how much is there? 0.1 mole. And Sr plus 2, how much? 0.2 moles. When we add what now? K2CrO4, 2. This K2CrO4 is added to what now? Ba plus 2 and also this Sr plus 2. Okay. Now ions precipitate out the Br plus 2. Br plus 2 ions will be precipitated out first. So we are adding what now? K2CrO4 to what? Ba plus 2 ions, 0.1 molar. And also we are adding the same salt to 0.1 molar Sr plus 2. Okay. Then when we add what now here? CrO4 minus 2 ions. Now, what will be compound formed here? Sr, CrO4 will form here. Here, what will be forming from this? Ba, CrO4 will form. Here, Ba will combine with anions. Here, Sr plus 2 will combine with anions to form strontium chromate, barium chromate. Okay, both are having 0.1 molar, 0.1 molar. Okay, and now which will be precipitated first, we have to understand. So Ba plus 2 ions will precipitate out first because the KSP solubility product of barium chromate is what? 1.2 into 10 power minus 10, which is lesser than what? KSP of SrCrO4. That is what? 3.5 into 10 power minus 5. It is in the order of 10 power minus 10. It is in the order of 10 power minus 5. Don't say 1.2 and 3.5. Don't say 3.5 is greater. Always. So here, what we have to say? So here 10 power minus 10 we have to see, 10 power minus 5 we see. Between 10 power minus 5 and 10 power minus 10, 10 power minus 10 is very lesser. 10 power minus 10 is very lesser than what? 10 power minus 5. Okay. How many times 10 power minus 10 is lesser? 5 times or 10 power 5 times? So 10 power 5 times, 1 lakh times, 10 power 5 times it is lesser than this one. That's why it is in the order of 10 power minus 7, which is very, very less than what? KSP of strontium chromate. So whichever is having less KSP value will be precipitated first. So between barium chromate formed, strontium chromate formed, which will be precipitated first? Barium chromate will be precipitated first because of lower KSP value. It is called fractional precipitation. Between two compounds, one will be precipitated first, then other will be precipitated. And solubility product can also be used in calculation of solubility of a sparingly soluble salt. Calculation of solubility of a sparingly soluble salt in presence of what? Strong electrolyte having common ion. For example, solubility of AgCl in NaCl. Here AgCl is what? Precipitate. Sparingly soluble salt. Sparingly soluble salt, that is precipitate. But NaCl is what now? Strong electrolyte. Now strong electrolyte has what? Cl minus. Here this precipitate also has Cl minus. Very less number of Cl minus will be produced from AgCl, but very large number of Cl minus will be produced from NaCl. So for example, solubility of AgCl in NaCl solution is very less, is less than in pure water. So AgCl will be dissolved more in pure water. In pure water, no common ion is there. That's why more solubility will be there in pure water. But AgCl solubility will be less in NaCl because of common ion. If common ion is present, the solubility of this salt will be very less. It will be decreased. Solubility will be decreased. This is explained as follows. AgCl solid in water, when we add to aqueous solution, it will dissociate incompletely into what? Ag plus aqueous and Cl minus aqueous. When we add NaCl solution to this, actual NaCl we can take directly, only one arrow. It is strong electrolyte, na? It will dissociate completely into Na plus and Cl minus. Now, what is common ion here? Cl minus is common ion. When common ion is added here, what happens now? Backward reaction will take place. Backward reaction taking place means what? AgCl will come out as precipitate. AgCl solid will be coming out from the solution in the form of precipitate. So precipitation occurs here. Okay, that means what? The solubility will be decreasing. Backward reaction taking place means what? The solubility of AgCl is decreasing. Okay? And in previous concept here, now when you are calculating what now KSP. KSP value fixed. Okay, it will be taken as what now here? KSP is taken as what? Ag plus into Cl minus now. Ag plus into Cl minus concentrations. Now Ag plus concentration, we don't know. Suppose S. It is S. And NaCl we dissolve here 0.1 molar. When NaCl is 0.1 molar, here one NaCl is giving 1 Cl minus. One NaCl gives 1 Cl minus. Then 0.1 will give how much? 0.1 molar. So what is concentration of Cl minus here? 0.1 molar. 0.1 molar. Now here, in this case, Cl minus concentration in this equation should be taken from AgCl Cl minus or from NaCl we have to substitute here. This one should be taken as what? 0.1 molar we have taken, Cl minus. The Cl minus should be taken from strong electrolyte only. The common ion, whatever is added, that concentration Cl minus should be taken. And AgCl KSP value will be given to you. KSP value will be given to you. And Cl minus, how much we have to take? 0.1 we have to take. And what we can calculate now? Ag plus concentration. Ag plus concentration is equal to what now? KSP value of AgCl divided by Cl minus concentration. The Cl minus concentration, how much should be taken here? Cl minus should be taken 0.1. And KSP value given, suppose in the problem. KSP value given and Cl minus we have to take from NaCl. Then we get Ag plus. This Ag plus concentration is nothing but solubility S. Solubility S we get. So like this, solubility should be calculated. Okay. So the AgCl solubility value will be less in presence of NaCl because of common ion. And the common ion Cl minus shifts the equilibrium backwards so that solid AgCl will be precipitated out in the previous equation. To calculate the exact solubility, the principle is that KSP of salt is constant irrespective of the source of ions. Now KSP of AgCl. KSP of AgCl will be fixed value. Whether the Cl minus concentration is 0.1 molar, 0.2 molar, 0.3 molar, whatever the source of Cl minus concentration, the KSP value will not change. KSP is fixed. KSP of AgCl is always equal to Ag plus concentration into Cl minus concentration. Here Cl minus is coming to be how much? 0.1, because NaCl concentration we have taken 0.1. That's why the Cl minus should be taken from NaCl concentration and KSP value will be given fixed and then we can find out Ag plus concentration. Okay. So, to calculate exact solubility, the principle is that KSP of a salt, any salt, is constant irrespective of the source of the ions. For example, 0.1 molar NaCl solution contains what? 0.1 molar Cl minus. As Cl minus ions from AgCl are very negligible. From AgCl also Cl minus coming, but it is sparingly soluble salt. So very less Cl minus will be coming here. But from NaCl, more Cl minus will be coming. Completely dissociates NaCl. So 0.1 molar NaCl completely will dissociate to give 0.1 molar Cl minus. That's why now Cl minus should be taken only from NaCl. We should not take Cl minus from AgCl because they are negligible. Hence Ag plus concentration into Cl minus concentration. This is what now here Cl minus concentration is equal to Ksp value of AgCl. Therefore, Ag plus concentration can be calculated by using formula Ksp by 0.1. This gives solubility of AgCl in NaCl. So this type of concept will be very important. Okay, concept of this one, very important. An important note is that knowing Ksp value of a sparingly soluble salt. Sparingly soluble means less soluble, very less soluble. Ksp of sparingly soluble, if you know, soluble acid here. What is given? Not salt, but acid is given here. So knowing Ksp value of sparingly soluble acid, the HX of the acid sizes, sparingly soluble acid, example what now? Benzoic acid. Benzoic acid formula C6H5COOH. C6H5COOH. Now this is a sparingly soluble acid. Okay, knowing the Ksp value of this type of acids, H plus concentration should be equal to what now? Square root of Ksp we have taken. If you know H plus concentration, what we can calculate pH? We can calculate na? Minus log of H plus ion concentration. Now H plus ion concentration is equal to what now? Square root of Ksp for this type of sparingly soluble acids. Example, benzoic acid is sparingly soluble acid. Hence, pH of the solution can be calculated by the formula what pH is equal to negative logarithm of H plus ion concentration. If H plus ion concentration is 10 power minus 3, minus log of 10 power minus 3 will be 3. Like that we can calculate pH. Next, conversely, knowing the pH value, Ksp can be calculated. Means what now here? Reverse. If you are given Ksp, we can get H plus. If you know H plus, we can get Ksp. So if pH is equal to 3, what will be H plus concentration? 10 power minus 3. So H plus concentration is always equal to 10 to the power of pH. 10 to the power of pH value. pH value 3 given here. That's why H plus concentration is 10 power minus 3. Then what we can take now here? Square root of Ksp is equal to H plus concentration. H plus concentration how much here? 10 power minus 3. Then Ksp we can get. Ksp is equal to 10 power minus 3 whole square. Like that, Ksp can be calculated if you know H plus. Or we can calculate H plus if you know Ksp. Similarly, knowing Ksp of sparingly soluble base now, MOH. MOH is one base here. Sparingly soluble base means what? Which is not completely dissolved. Very less solubility is there for this. So in this case now, OH minus concentration of this base should be taken as what? Square root of Ksp of this base. Ksp of the base we have taken here. So OH minus concentration is equal to under root Ksp of the base, sparingly soluble base. Then the H plus concentration should be taken as what generally? We know that H plus into OH minus is equal to what now? Kw, no? Kw how much? 10 power minus 14 we know. Now if you know OH minus now from Ksp, then H plus we can get now. H plus is equal to what now here? 10 power minus 14 Kw by OH minus. So Kw by OH minus we can take here. It is PKW, means Kw. H plus concentration is equal to Kw value 10 power minus 14 by OH minus concentration. This OH minus we are getting from which formula? Square root of Ksp for the sparingly soluble base. So after getting OH minus, we substitute OH minus here. This OH minus. After that, we get what? H plus concentration. If you know H plus concentration, what we can get? pH. pH is equal to minus log of H plus concentration. So this is important concept of what? Solubility product. Okay. And here, different types of salts. Yesterday, I told you. Acidic salts, basic salts, which will produce H plus ions are called acidic salts. And which will produce OH minus ions are called basic salts. Acidic salts will produce H plus, basic salts will produce OH minus. Again, so different types of salts we have already discussed. So today we have discussed about important topic, applications of solubility products. Application soluble product. Now one more thing, remember here, if you take what now here, two important areas here, see. Suppose we have taken what now here, pH of solution of mixture of two weak acids. How many weak acids? Two weak acids. When we take two weak acids here, what will be H3O plus concentration? H3O plus concentration, nothing but H plus concentration. Remember, if you know H plus concentration, we can get pH. So H3O plus or H plus concentration is equal to under root Ka1C1. Here Ka1 is what, dissociation constant of first acid. C1 is the concentration of first acid plus Ka2C2. Take screenshot of this. Under root Ka1C1 plus Ka2C2 is equal to H plus concentration. When you mix two weak acids. And suppose when we mix for a mixture of weak acid with concentration C1 and ionization constant Ka, weak acid. And strong acid we are taking here, C2 concentration. C2 is the concentration of strong acid, C1 is weak acid. Ka will be only for weak acid. Now H3O plus concentration or H plus concentration is equal to C2 plus under root C2 square plus 4Ka1C by 2. Okay, C2 plus under root C2 square plus 4KaC1 by 2.